Hey, what's going on, guys? Keith Carpenter back here today with another video. I want to take you inside of pipelines. Being in the mortgage industry for many years, I actually created a software product for the mortgage industry between 2006 and 2008. So you can imagine how that went. I wanted to kind of talk about pipelines and how it can not only keep everything organized inside of your Market Chief CRM, but also automate things as they're happening. I think it's amazing. You know, technology is great, and I think you're going to find a lot of value in this. So let's hop right in. So you can see here, I'm inside the pipeline section here on the left, and we have three pipelines set up in here. So we have a mortgage pipeline, we have a mortgage basic pipeline, and then there's this mortgage complex pipeline, right? So it's more like it starts as a new lead, makes its way all the way down to, you know, all the way to the end. Okay. So you can build your own pipelines. You can build them exactly the way you want them with the exact stages based on, you know, your own situation inside your office. But the real magic is being able to have a lead in here and then drag it across to over here or have it move automatically over here when something is done. That's just amazing in and of itself. But then the ability to have something else happen because that happened is really the power of automation, and it's the power of Market Chief. Now, one thing you're going to realize when you start using this type of software is you can achieve the same outcome in a few different ways, right? You can use the automations to achieve the same outcome doing different things, and you'll see that as you get into the software and start using it for your own business. But right now, I want to show you a way that this would work with the pipelines and the automations in the real world. So the first thing that we need is a form to get filled out. And when that happens, then the information of the person is put into Market Chief and a lead is created here inside of this pipeline mortgage complex. Okay. So let's head over to the marketing section. Let's click on form builder, and you can see we don't have any forms here yet. So we're going to come over here and click here to create a form. Then on the right, I'm just going to drag out a few pieces of information. And I'm going to assume that for this example, we're just saying, hey, that maybe this is a form, and I'm not saying this is best practice. I'm just saying for the sake of getting this done in this time frame in this video, let's just say they opted in to want to speak to you about getting a mortgage. Okay. They decided that, you know, hey, I'm ready to talk to somebody. They put their first name, their phone number, their email, just basic information to get them through the door. Maybe you're like, hey, you know what? I'd rather get their full name. So get their full name and let's get this out of here. And now we have a form, okay? On the right side over here, we can put in the form and just say, we'll call this interested in mortgage, okay? And then we'll deal with the settings and all that later. So basically, we have this form. We can stylize it however we want. The button itself, I can click on this and then put in here, yes, you know, please help me get the best financing. You know, something like that. Okay. So now we have a form. It's called Interested in Mortgage, and now it's in the system. So literally I can use this form on my website or on my funnel to bring people in and then push them into the system to have other things happen. So the next thing we're going to need is a page to put this on. So let's go to pages. Let's go to funnels. I need to save this. So come down to the bottom and click save form. I almost forgot that, right? But it didn't let me. So that's good. Now let's go over here to pages, click on funnels. And we are going to just create a new funnel, okay? Just for this example, we'll call this pipelines example video. Hit create funnel. So here's our funnel, okay? I'm gonna add a new step. I'm gonna call this opt-in or interested in mortgage. We'll say the path is just gonna be interested in mortgage. That's the URL. So after your domain /, hit create funnel step. Then we're going to go in here to this page, and typically I'd have a header. You can have a global header so that it's just, you pop it out and you can put it on any page. I'm just going to go like this real quick, and I'm going to put in column and an element, and we're going to go ahead and choose form, and I'm going to choose the form that we just made, interested in mortgage. Then I'm going to come up in the top here, click on save. Once that's done, I'm going to click on preview, and here's our page. Okay. So I can go in here and opt in. So we're going to leave that there for 1 second. Let's go back into here, back out of this, and we're going to come over here to marketing, and we're going to click on campaigns. and I'm going to click on a new folder. I'm going to call this Keith Test, and I'm going to click on create campaign, and we'll call this interested in mortgage. Again, I'm just kind of keeping it real simple here. Keith Test, save. So now this is a campaign inside the folder. So we'll see that when we go back out. And so what we're going to do is click on this add event, and we're going to choose an email, and we're going to say interested in mortgage welcome. And you'll have a subject line. Typically you'll say like RE colon your interest in a mortgage loan dot dot dot. Again, that's not a good subject line. I'm just trying to move. We'll say hi. We'll do custom value. We'll say hi first name period. And we'll say, we received your information about mortgage loan approval, right? And then you'll go on to say whatever. And then whoever the user is, whoever it's been assigned to, we're going to go user, and we're going to go user full name. And you can even go deeper than that, right? You can go user email. You can go user phone. You can go user Zoom link. You can do a custom value here. So, this is good. Typically you're going to put like their title here, right? So whatever that is. And then that's how you kind of structure it, right? Whatever, however you write the email, you're going to click on save. You can send a test from there as well. Now, obviously you're going to add more events to this and trick it out, right? And make it, think it through. That's the fun of it, right? You're actually creating a sales process that works for you, right? Not against you in some cases. So we can see it's in draft mode. We're going to come up here to the right-hand corner. We're going to click on this box, hit published. That's going to publish this for us. So now that it's live and ready to go. And then now we have to do what's called an automation trigger, which tells the system, hey, if somebody fills that form out, put them in this campaign among other actions, right? So let's go over to automations down here in the bottom, and I'll create a test folder for this. Call it Keith Test, save. And then I'm going to create a trigger. So I'm going to hit add trigger. We'll do interested in mortgage, and we will put it in Keith's test folder, hit save. Now, this is the fun part. Which event should trigger this automation? So you can choose a Facebook event, but for this, we're going to choose a Market Chief event. And we're going to say that customer, form submitted. So click on form submitted, and then we're going to hit add filter, and we're going to choose form is, and then we're going to select form interested in mortgage, right? How easy is that? So now the system says, okay, when this form is submitted, what do you want me to do? Well, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add the opportunity to a pipeline, and we're going to add it to mortgage complex. We're going to put it in the new lead stage, and we're just going to come down and select status and put open. You can fill this stuff in if you want, and you could give it a value, however much your leads are worth. And there's other settings here, but let's keep moving. So let's add action. Now from here, we can do a few things that are really important. Okay. So number one is adding a contact tag. Okay. So we go contact tag and we say interested in mortgage. Okay. We're keeping the line, right? Everything's real familiar. So now anybody that fills that form out is going to get this tag, which means you'll be able to find them in your database as it grows. Now let's click add action again, and we're going to choose add to campaign, and we're going to choose the campaign that we created called interested in mortgage. And that's going to put this lead, any lead that fills that form out is going to get put into the interested in mortgage campaign that we created. I'm going to click add action. Typically you're going to want to notify yourself, right? So you'll come down here and say send SMS, and then you're going to want to put your phone number in here. So I'd put my number in here, and then I would say you just got a new lead. And what's cool is you can actually put custom values in here too, right? So full name, just requested information about a mortgage, right? And then, you can even, if you're the owner and you have people working for you, you can say the user, and you could even like write it like this, this lead has been assigned to, and then you could put username, okay? Now, that's one thing I didn't mention up here. If you're gonna be assigning leads to a user, I would do that first. That would be the first action that would take place here. But since we don't have any users in here, we're not going to do that. But I will show you something. If I click add action and we go to assign to user, when there are users in here, you can choose multiple users, and it will basically rotate those through either on a round robin basis, which is evenly, or you can choose who gets how many percentage of the leads. So it's pretty cool. So I'm going to get rid of that. Just click on the X. and I'm going to scroll to the top and click on save. And then I'm going to click right here and I'm going to publish or activate this. Okay. So we're activate it and I'm going to click out with this arrow here. And we're back here where we have our test trigger, interested in mortgage. You can see that it's active and I can edit it if I'd like to. Okay. Can also move it around, but let's keep on track. So now let's go back to this form here. So when I fill this form out, a few things should happen, right? This is going to push the information into the CRM and it's going to trigger this automation and everything that we just told it to do, it's going to do, including adding it to this campaign here called Interested in Mortgage. And then this email will fire out right away. And if we're going to do it immediately, typically I'll just choose immediately over here and that's it. You don't have to save this. It saves and then just click out and there you go. So you can see it's published. So now let's go back over to this page here and we're going to fill your form out. Let's fill the form out and let's put, okay, let's click on yes, help me get financing. And it's going to return back to this page because we didn't tell it where to go, but we can easily tell it what to do and how to behave once the form is filled out. Now we're going to come back inside here and we're going to go into contact smart lists. And we can see that we have a new contact. Okay. We have Andy Gosher. We have his information. We have the fact that it came through right now on February 10th. And then we have a tag interested in mortgage. Pretty cool, right? So now he's in here. He came through for my advertising or my marketing or whatever. And now he just got a message. So if I click on Andy Gosher, right away, you can see we received the information about your mortgage loan approval, blah, 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 right? We didn't fill it out, but that's what went out to Andy. So let's back out of here. Andy is now in the system, which is very cool. Let's go to pipelines. Let's go here to mortgage complex and let's have that refresh here. And you'll see here that Andy's in here. Looks like that lead I put in here is in here and we can see the tag. And of course we can choose what we want to show up for information over here on the right. And you can choose what information you want on the actual card. Now, if you move this, cause you can drag this right or left. Okay. You can move it around or when you win it, lose it or abandon it, you can drop it down here in the bottom to tell the system, hey, I won this. Or we lost this. Okay. And then abandon. Okay. So you can drag it or you can drag it here. And in which case, when you drag it over, let me just go here. If you drag it over here and drop it in responded, you can have an automation set up that will automatically trigger something else to happen because of this being dragged over here. Okay. But as well as if something else happens in the system, you can create an automation trigger to tell the system to move this over here automatically to respond it. So sorry for the long video. I know there's a lot here we went through, but I hope it gives you some more insight into the power of having not just the CRM, but an entire marketing machine in one place to help you grow your mortgage business. So if you have any questions, we're here for you. Schedule a call with a rep if you're interested in learning how we can get going with Market Chief and have a great day.